Hi, this is Pastor Craig, and I'd like to welcome you to this edition of Ask Pastor Craig. Thank you for joining me this evening. My question tonight is this. I am a Christian who has a lot of hang-ups. I have a lot of things that I'm in bondage to. And while I really want to be free, I'm struggling to break these chains. What should I do? Thank you very much for your question. I really appreciate it. And, you know, you don't mention specifically what kind of things you're in bondage to, which is fine. And certainly there'd be some areas probably that I'm not qualified to discuss. But in my opinion, most things are spiritual. Most things have a spiritual core or root to them. And so let me talk specifically regarding that. You know, my personal opinion is that most of us don't experience the kind of freedom that we could or even that we should, because we really deny the kind of power that God has given to us. Let me read to you a scripture in the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8. The Bible says, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you." You know, this is a really interesting scripture when you study it out, because this word power is a Greek word, and the word is dunamis. And dunamis is a word that means an act of power, miraculous power, the ability to do anything, the ability to perform anything. So it's a dynamic power. It's an explosive power, and that's the kind of power that God wants us to experience through the Holy Spirit. That's the kind of power that God wants us to experience in our bondages and in our shortcomings, in our timidity, or whatever the case may be. This dynamic power that was given to us through the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 1 verse 8 isn't the only time that word is used. We also find it in 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 20 when the Apostle Paul says, "The kingdom of God is not a matter of words, but of power." And again, that word dunamis, that dynamic power of God that is given to us through the infilling of the Holy Spirit. You know, most of us, for whatever reason, have a faith that is very tame, that is very domesticated, like a lion in a cage or a dog on a chain. Most of us don't experience the kind of power that God has given to us. Most of us don't experience the kind of incredible freedom and liberty that God gave to us through the cross of Christ, through the infilling of the Holy Spirit. And perhaps that comes from teaching. Maybe it comes from just not being given over to God enough, or just simply not knowing about this power of the Holy Spirit. But nonetheless, it is a gift that is given to every single child of God, everyone that calls upon the name of the Lord, Acts chapter 2 tells us. So, you know, if you feel very limited in your experience with God, if you feel like you're not experiencing this incomparable, indomitable, incredible power of God through the Holy Spirit, then you're not experiencing all that God has for you. And I really want to encourage you to realize that God's given us a very incredible gift through the Holy Spirit. You know, we don't oftentimes, many denominations or churches don't talk much about the Holy Spirit and His role in our life. But it's really a great study. And I encourage you to break open your Bible and to really dive in to find out exactly what the Holy Spirit's job is in your life, the kind of power that God has given you through the Holy Spirit, and then begin to experience and walk in that power. Really encourage you to do that today, because truly we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. We have this incomparable, indomitable power that God has given to us. And so I encourage you to explore that. You know, I think it'll be a big help for you. I think it'll really change your life. I can tell you that it has been a radical transformation for me, and I hope to continue to allow God to transform me more and more. You know, if you have more questions about this specific question or topic, we'd really like to hear from you. If you have a question that's not related to this, we'd still really like to hear from you. You can do that in a couple of ways. You can reach us at this radio program's Facebook page, which is facebook.com/ROR Ministries. You can reach me at my church's Facebook page, which is facebook.com/Heartland Christian Center. Or you can reach me at my Facebook page, which is facebook.com/Pastor Craig Online. God bless you for listening this evening. In Jesus' name.